Hello everyone and welcome back to School Gaps. School World Gaps. If you don't know who we are, then we are where we help you to solve hard exams and study well. So now, in this PPT, in this video right here, what we will see? In this video, we will see about, first we will see introduction, then the timeline, then we will see about the main equations of motion, and at the last, at the end, we will do summary. So in this module, we will see about equations of motion. As I said, there are shortcuts to calculate many things such as acceleration, speed, displacement, many more things. Also, this thing right here, we will solve some questions, interesting questions. And now let us see the timeline. So in the timeline, in the first term or part, you studied about the introduction, what is motion and its terms. In the second part, you saw about the speeds, velocities, and acceleration, displacement, distance, etc. In the third part, you use about kinematic graphs, yeah? And now, we will see about the equations of motion. Then, let me introduce you to many terms right here. So, the first term is S, which is equal to displacement. Then A, which is equal to acceleration. T is time. V is the final velocity, U is the initial velocity, and that is it. So now, it is the time for the first equation of motion. Here is the first equation of motion. So, first equation of motion is kindly an equation which tells you about the final velocity from initial velocity, acceleration and time. The law or the equation is so simple. It is just V is equals to U plus AT. That is final velocity is equals to the initial velocity plus acceleration into time. So now let us see how to get the first equation of motion. Let's zoom in. Okay, so we get the first equation of motion from a very simple term, that is acceleration. First, let's take acceleration. You know the formula, A is equals to V minus U by T. Now, this is an equation, okay? So you can change terms. When we take the T, which is in division, to the left hand side, we multiply it. So it is AT is equals to V minus U. U is added here to get AT plus U is equals to V. You all know the thing which is called commutativity. Where, in addition, if you change the terms, the thing or the equation remains the same. Therefore, U plus AT is equals to V. Or V is equals to U plus AT. This is the equation derived from a very simple term, as I said, acceleration. If there was a ball falling from a mountain hill, it starts from rest and takes 50 seconds to reach the ground. Assuming that the gravitational force was applied, what velocity is it attaining at its last point? So this is your first question about, and it's related about the first equation of motion. It's an easy question, just you need to think. So I have marked important terms in red, that is starts from rest. Its initial velocity, that is 0 meter per second. Then I have marked 50 seconds. So there is a time. It takes 50 seconds to come down. Then I have marked gravitational force. If you don't know gravitational acceleration, we have done it in our first videos. You may see it. The link is in the description. Also, what I want to say is that gravitational force acceleration is 9.8 meter per second. And we can round up it and take it as 10 meter per second squared. And then they have asked us at its last point, what is its final velocity? We all know the equation v is equals to u plus at. If we continue that equation, we will get v is equals to u, that is 0, cancel it, plus at. A is 10 and t is 50. So 10 into 50 is 500. It's just a question, so it may work. So it is 500 meter per second. The velocity of the ball is 500 meter per second at its last point on its ground. So 0 to the second equation of motion. This is kind of a complex but easy equation. It tells us the displacement from initial velocity, time and acceleration. Let us see the formula. Formula is s is equals to ut plus half at squared, which is displacement is equals to initial velocity into time plus half the time in time squared into acceleration. Let me give you an example. For example, the initial velocity is 1. The displacement is not yet given. We need to find it. The time is 2 seconds and the acceleration is 4 meter per second square. So, here what we do is s is equals to 1 into t, that is 2, which is equals to 2 plus 1 by 2 into 4 into 2 squared, that is 4, which is finally equal to 8, and 2 plus 8 is equals to 10. Therefore, 10 meters is the displacement.
So now this is time for the third equation. So you all know that velocity is equals to displacement by time. Now, we can change it. Displacement is equals to velocity into time. Velocity, here we are talking about average velocity, that is u plus v by 2 whole into time. Now you all know that v is equals to u plus at. So let's change it. U plus at by 2 whole into t is equals to displacement. So here also let us notice that 2u plus at by 2 into t is the equation right here. When we break it down, you notice that it is 2u by 2 to cancel, plus 1 by 2 at. Now let this bracket be multiplied by t. S is equals to, therefore when we multiply it, we get s is equals to ut plus half at squared. This is your second equation of motion.
A truck is moving on a straight road. It starts from 10 meter per second square and stops after a certain distance. It is affected by a frictional force of 5 newton and is decelerating at 5 meter per second square. It stops after 2 seconds. What is the distance covered? This is your second question. So now here's the answer. Let's zoom in. You can see right here. So I have marked some important terms, that is 10 meter per second square, that is its initial velocity, then comes 2 seconds, that is its time, 5 meter per second, that is its deceleration, or deceleration is negative acceleration, which is equals to, therefore acceleration is minus 5 meter per second square. And the last term is what is the distance travel. So I have added a tricky thing, that is 5 newton frictional force. It is not helpful in this question, it is just for tricking, and yeah, it is not helpful here. So you know the second equation, that is s equals to ut plus 1 by half plus half at squared. So here s we need to find, which is equals to initial velocity, which is given, that is 10 meter per second square, 10 into time 2, so 20 plus half a, that is minus 5, into t, that is 2 squared is 4. So it becomes 20 plus whole. Here if we do the calculations, it becomes minus 10. Yeah, it becomes minus 10. So 20 minus 10 is equals to 10. Therefore, it has covered a distance of 10 meters since it was started and it ended at the certain distance spot. This is the third and last equation of motion. It is a simple equation. It gives us the velocity, again, yes, the final velocity from initial velocity, acceleration, because you might be wondering, the last term is time. No, it is displacement, yes. A bit different from the first one, but let us see. The law or the equation is v squared is equals to u squared plus 2as. So now, deviation of the third equation of motion. Let us zoom in. You can see right here. So how to deviate this certain equation? It is so easy. Displacement is equals to velocity into time. You know that. Now again, we are talking about the average velocity. So it is final velocity plus initial velocity by 2. That is v plus u by 2 into time. Now, remember our first equation, what is it? Yeah, so it is v is equals to u plus at. Here, if we do some rearrangements, we get t is equals to v minus u by a. Let us replace t and substitute it by a, like a football player does if he does not play well. Okay, so here t is not playing well. So let us just replace it by v minus u by a. When we multiply these both terms, so we finally, like I want to say, s is equals to v plus u by 2 whole into whole v minus u by a. So when we multiply, we just multiply it like that. So 2a is the denominator, and in the numerator, you know the identity, right? A minus b into a plus b is equals to a squared minus b squared. So it is v squared minus u squared. V squared minus u squared by 2a is equals to s. When we take 2a that side, we get v squared minus u squared is equals to 2as. When we add the minus u squared that side, we get u squared plus 2as is equals to v, or v is equals to u squared plus 2as. This is your third question and the last question. The distance I used is not the real distance, so do not worry. The question says it. A train moves on its railway track from Mumbai to Delhi. It starts from rest. It moves with a constant acceleration of 30 meters per second square and covers a distance of 1500 meters. Find the final velocity. It is so simple, I already marked the terms. That is, initial velocity, 0 starts from rest. Constant acceleration is 30 meters per second squared. Then comes the distance, displacement, that is 1500 meters. Now we need to find the final velocity. So, v squared is equals to u squared plus 2as. U squared is 0, so 0, no value, remove it. 2as, 2 into 30 into 1500. Here I say, as the if I would use a large distance, I need to change the terms. So that is something which you should mind it. Then comes 2 into 1500 into 30 is equals to 90,000. V squared is equals to 90,000. V is equals to root, square root 90,000, which is 300 into 300 is 90,000. Therefore, the final velocity is 300 meter per second squared. So now, why I say constant acceleration? It is necessary for every question or anything that is related to these three laws or equations. We need constant acceleration, that is the one acceleration. If there were many acceleration or it used to change, the question is not valid or these equations cannot work. So now this is the summary. Yeah, so what you learned in this module is so simple. Laws of equations, equations of motion, which help you to take shortcuts, as I say in one game. First law, first equation, v is equals to u plus at. Final velocity is equals to initial velocity plus acceleration into time. Second one is s is equals to ut plus 1 by 2 at squared. Third one, v squared is equals to u squared plus 2as. That is it. Thank you everyone for watching. Like, share, and subscribe Squirrel Gaps. Credit goes to slidesco.com and Freepik for the good PPT design template.
Like, share, and subscribe Squirrel Gaps. Meet you guys in the next video. New series will start soon. And also, now every Sunday we are uploading a video in which we will tell about regular things and new, very exciting things. So like, share, and subscribe Squirrel Gaps.